in no APC journal for publication your paper. So this is one path, bold path. And as a library professional, some of the library professionals are here. For the academia, the most important resource is primary source. For us, the most important resource is tertiary source. Now, what is the tertiary source for the green path? So green path is in compare with the gold path, green path is basically something different. Green path is slightly complex also. Say I have published a paper in a commercial journal, which is a copyrighted journal. But still, as an author, I have the right to upload the preprint version of my paper or postprint version of my paper in any of the open access repositories. Then suppose I am a student of economics or sociology. How I can know that how this commercially articles published in different commercial journals available in my domain? What are the tertiary tools or meta tools? So Lund University developed this DOAJ, and universities are coming a big way to support open access movement. So DOAJ is built by the initially by the Lund University. Then another tertiary tool in the green path is OpenDoor, developed by Nottingham University. So I want to retrieve very quickly that how many repositories are there in the domain of sociology or economics. Let me show you how can I do it. I can now click the advanced search here. In the advanced search, it is supported by a set of subject headings we call normally Library of Congress subject heading. So if you go scroll down below, you see here subject. These are all Library of Congress border subject heading. I can select any of these: geography, language, history, philosophy, and so on. So you see science and social science equally represented. Now suppose I am interested in education. So I'm selecting education and clicking search. So all the repositories in the domain of education now listed alphabetically. Any of these I can click, go and search, or I can search comprehensively under this search button. And there are altogether 239 repositories on education. And if in, on an average, each of them includes around 10,000 articles, so you can do your math, 239 into 10,000 articles. So this much amount of information available free of cost for individual as well as for libraries. So this is one thing related to journals paper, but students, those who are present in this particular webinar, they need textbook. Teachers sometimes also need textbook to refer for their student. So here, beautiful site developed by the same pan-European community who are now presently supporting DOAJ. So this is called DOAB, Directory of Open Access Books. So at presently, there are 30,000 textbooks available. These are all quality textbooks, because just like DOAJ quality journal, these are all quality textbooks available. Anyone can download, anyone can integrate. All are available under Creative Commons licensing. So this is about a book. Now, if you are interested about thesis, so one of the tool is called OATB. You all know that thesis, full text thesis now available in India through South Ganga. This is the national thesis repository. Similarly, many countries have come up with their own thesis repositories. NDLTD from US, then Ethos from UK. So almost all countries are having their national thesis repository, South Ganga for India. So instead of roaming around all these thesis repository, you can directly come to this particular open OATD. You can search here 30 million full text thesis available, which actually gathered all thesis metadata from different national thesis repositories of the world. So instead of roaming around every thesis repositories around the world, you can come to OATD, developed by a consortium of European university, and you can have your full text thesis at different level, master's level, PhD level, etc. Now this another tool developed by combining this DOAJ, DOAB and OATD, one single platform is BASE, developed by Bielefeld University Library, and powered by the open source software like Apache Solr and ViewFind. So I am also slightly attached with this particular platform. I will tell you what contribution we have made. So presently it includes 206 million resources coming from different open access channels. And 206 million resources is not a matter of joke. 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. So 206 into 10 lakhs of resources available in the form of thesis, in the form of book, in the form of journal, technical writing, and many more. And suppose if I search by something like, open learning here, open learning, you see how is it different from your Google search. In case of academic search, do not go to Google, come to this, developed by a librarian, and media search of a librarian is there. Now here, you see here, I can easily restrict my search very easily under author or under title or under subject. So that is, you can restrict your search in Google by title, but not by author, not by subject. And you see the display of the retrieved document. Right from here, I can take a decision because author is there, year of publication, publisher, document type. In some cases, for article cases, there will be also include a kind of short description. So here you see the description. In the next also you see description. And here you see it is boosted for the open access. This is the symbol developed by UNESCO for representing a document as open access. So 90% of the resources covered by base is open access. And this is the beauty. And anything I can select, if I click the full text paper, this hyperlink title, the full text of this particular document will be coming to me. So let it come. And let me show you other advantages of this. If you click the advanced search, it's really very advanced in comparison with your Google. Just like a library, you can select any of the field for field level searching, title, author, publisher, subject heading. You can select here the document type. By default, all is selected. I can select, I need only book. Then I can select country or continent. I want everything from Asia. I want everything from India. So all countries are given in alphabetical order, including the continent. Then I can go for range search also. I want information from this year to that year. And even there is a scale. I can use this particular scale. So otherwise you can type. Then I can go for different kind of licensing and everything. So this is one thing. Next important thing, as a librarian, we all know that retrieval is a judicious mixture of search and browse. And most of the search tools, both commercial and open access, like Google, Google Scholar, Scopus, etc., they do not give any kind of browsing option. But here you see, I can browse also, even by DDC. And most of the users who go to the stacks, they know that books are arranged by DDC class number. So if I click DDC call number, you see, I can have the first order division of DOE, second order division of DOE, third order division of DOE, and so on. So this is the first order division within bracket number of documents. Suppose I am interested in social sciences. If I click, second order division will come. If I am interested in economics, third order divisions will come. So within bracket number of documents. Again, you can search by your class number. You ask your librarian friend that what is the class number of your domain of interest. Say I'm interested in chemistry. I can retrieve everything from base in one go. I know the base class of chemistry is 540. So DDC colon 540. Even I can go up to the third order summary of DDC. Suppose 549, crystallography. So 594,000 resources are there. But if I search by third order division like 5.9 mineralogy and crystallography, you see here the number of documents will be reduced. Only 28 resources are on crystallography and mineralogy. So in this way, we can search very quickly, all resources on a given domain. So after base, another important thing in open access domain, this is the newly introduced service. This is base, and this is the front end of base. Let me tell you that what it can do additionally. So it can take at the back end either PubMed or base. Now PubMed is for biology, base is multidisciplinary. So I am taking base here. Now suppose I am searching the same open learning here.
Now, what is the difference? This is a very important thing, tool for researcher and teacher. I can categorize all papers belonging to the domain of open learning for systematic review. If I click, you see here, it will create a map for me. So all the facets related to open learning will be created first. Then it will include within those bubble how many core papers are there. It takes hardly 20 seconds to create the map for you. But take it from me, it's a very useful tool if you are trying to do a kind of literature review, kind of a systematic study on a given domain. And so for researcher and teacher, it's a very important tool. Apart from this, so it's a combination of base plus open knowledge map. So they are taking base at the background and creating maps at the front end. And seeing is believing. After seeing this, you will believe that how helpful it can be. So sometimes it can take a little bit of extra time. Let it take its time. Okay, it's done. Now, after this is over, you see it can present, you see here, different bubble. So enter open knowledge movement they developed into open education, distance education, knowledge mapping, project-based learning, interactive group learning. Now, suppose I am interested in data and MOOCs. So if I click here, you see, these four are the core papers related to this bubble. So all these core papers I can start with, then I can study the references and I can build my own citation network. So it's a very advantageous, use it and you won't leave it. That is a guaranteed thing. So apart from this base and other things, Microsoft presently coming in a big way. So that is Microsoft Academic Search, and those who have previously utilized Bing search engine, now I request all of you to revisit Microsoft Academic Graph, MAG. It's a completely open source now, and you can search directly here. It includes around 174 million resources. But I always advise that do not try to use Microsoft Academic Graph, because it's a searching is slightly advanced level. Instead of that, just like Open Knowledge Map, you can utilize lens.org. Lens.org is a front end of Microsoft Academic Graph. You see here, it's a text from academic 178 million resources, from cross-net 114, PubMed Core and PubMed Central. So altogether, they combine these things very lucidly and seamlessly here. Now suppose I'm searching here the same open learning. You see, you don't need nowadays a single commercial source. It's completely open access, and you see the comprehensiveness of the services. So it retrieved actually all the resources scholarly. I can sort by relevance, just like Scopus. I can sort by highest citation, lowest citation, etc. Suppose I'm sorting by the papers by number of citations. Then it retrieved around 27,000 resources. And right here it can tell me whether it's open access, whether full text available or not, how many citations is received, what is the arithmetic score of this particular paper, everything, how many references included, everything I can know from here, including the abstract. And another comprehensive search, you see, I want to now go for analytics. So this is listing and this is analysis. If I click analysis button, the entire open learning, what I searched by here, open learning, the particular domain will be analyzed very quickly. And here you see what is the result of this analysis. It can identify who are the most prolific contributor, institute and person, how this particular field is growing. So right from 2000 to how it is picking up the particular term and concept, what are the core area or top field of research, say computer science is actually producing material, psychology is producing, pedagogy is producing, medical science is producing. So all top field of search will be there. Then there are different other kind of graphics representation. And take it from me, I am a regular user of Scopus. Scopus database. This kind of facility is not even available in Scopus, which cost around rupees 10 lakhs per annum. So there are various, you know, equal low cost and no cost alternative nowadays for different kind of open access resources. And always, as a library professional, as a teaching community, target to know what are the tertiary tools available so that it can lead you to the primary source. If you want to, you know, go for different kind of learning object, my suggestion and strong advice is that you please explore open OER Commons. That's a supported presently by UNESCO. You can select your subject, you can select the educational level right from nursery school to PG, every, you know, standard you can select. Now if you can search after your keywords, it can produce a complete package in the form of zip file. That package you can download and you can use inside your learning system. Now the question is that the same tool is Teaching Common. Teaching Common is also providing you, this is a sharing platform for teachers. Suppose I have developed some open learning object, I can share those objects here so that other teachers can be benefited. Similarly, I can also consume. So it's a teaching sharing platform for teaching teachers all around the world, teachingcommon.us. And now I am going to show you that how this or everything can be integrated inside our library. So presently you see our Ministry of HRD is proposing a four quadrant model, and I almost forget my presentation. Okay, let's come. I will take another 10 minutes only. Saptarshi, sorry. I hope there will be no problem for another 10 minutes.
No, you just carry on.
Okay. So what is our Ministry of HRD is proposing, that when you are providing a e-learning kind of thing, virtual learning is the new normal, as Saptarshi proposed in his title of presentation. So this VL is the new normal, and the model we need to follow is called the four quadrant model. In the quadrant one, you have to develop a e-tutorial or video tutorial. In the quadrant two, you have to develop against a particular topic. So again, you need to be very structured. Say, suppose you take your curricula, the entire syllabus. Curricula is divided into number of papers. You go through the papers. Each paper includes number of units. Under each unit, there are topics. So you have to target that topic. And against every topic, you have to give four parameters. The parameter one or quadrant one is the video tutorial need to be developed by your own, or you can take any of the open learning object related to your topic. Quadrant two, you have to prepare a 10-page or 3,000 word limited e-text or slide presentation. Quadrant three, a list of web resources related to your topic, and here open access resources can be very useful, and your librarian colleagues can help you as a teacher to support your teaching learning evaluation. And quadrant four is the evaluation. So if this is the model, we actually develop this VLE. As I said, most of the tools I am going to tell you here are all open source. I have not spent a single paisa of my university in developing this one. We developed this by using moodlecloud.com. Here you can see any teacher is welcome to utilize this moodlecloud.com. So we are running presently four courseware here. Now suppose any of this courseware, if I click, you see here how four quadrant learning actually looks like. So in the generic section, you can give objective of the course, glossary, a chat box where you can go for different kind of doubt clearing session. Then you can give an online classroom. Now this Zoom, Google Meet, these are actually not meant for online classroom. Online teaching is basically supported by different domain specific software. These are also open source. I am using here Big Blue Button. It gives me a virtual whiteboard where I can write, I can highlight. Many other things which I cannot do in Zoom, WebEx, or Google Meet. So these are actually web conferencing software. We need to adapt a true online classroom things. So this is there. Now, if we go to this unit, every unit starts with the topic. So suppose this is the topic, ILS transition. Now, each of this particular topic, if I come down, is again supported by UC. First, I always start with a reading list. Then it's followed by a text. So this is the quadrant three, the reading list on the topic. Then the quadrant one, text on ILS transition. So I prepare a summary note kind of thing. The lecture note you normally share. So the soft copy of that can be embedded here. My student can go through it. So it can also be supported by a list of further references. Then after this text reading is over, my student can come back for presentation. So this is again, both are coordinate one, both e-text and presentation. Now, just I'm showing you that how a presentation looks. So this presentation is again embedded. They can download, they can go for it, they can visualize here, anything they can do. Then I start my coordinate one, that is the video tutorial after the e-text is over. Then I also advise the same for you, that you open a Vimeo channel or YouTube channel on behalf of your college. Because if you upload your video in Moodle, your performance of your server will be lowered, because video streaming is a different ballgame. So almost all educational institutes of the world, either they use Vimeo is slightly academic, or YouTube. So I also opened up YouTube channel, developed my 25 to 30 minute video, embedded that video here, and here you see after embedding how does it look like. So my student can start this video. This is coming from YouTube, the entire streaming. They can go for different kind of full screen mode. They can go forward, go backward.
Real trained setting process started in library automation in the decade of 80s. In the decade of 80s, with the advent of the low-cost computer, personal computer in different forms.
So now you can have an idea how, what is an, now I'm going back. Now after going back, my student can appear. I can go for the last page, that is the evaluation. I can allow them to submit resources. I can go for different kind of MCQ based evaluation. I can publish the result after 2 minutes of the examination, and after every assignment and MCQ is over, I can publish the grade book, final grade book for the unit one. So all are system generated. You don't have to do anything apart from setting your weightage formula and other things. So everything is automatic. So it's what teacher. Now how you see library can be integrated inside here. So this is another course we are running for second semester. Now suppose I have shown you base searching. Now I can integrate any number of resources through latest technology called LTI, Learning Tools Interoperability. Now suppose my student, this is a course on a content designator, can search anything about web indexing. Now right from here they can have resources, they don't have to go outside. So I can integrate here. I have integrated an open access search engine called possibly Base. So the result will be coming Base, and you see my learner is not going outside of this particular environment. So result is coming here. Now they can go through, they can download, they can do anything within the same interface. Same is the case with other search and bibliographic resources. I can integrate WorldCat, IndCat, and in my local OPAC. So for example, I am searching, as Nimai talked about Rovindranath. Now you see here, I'm searching something called Gitanjali. Let me check. Now my student can search right from here. And without going to the library will be coming up. Nowadays the theory is that if Muhammad is not going to the Parbat needs to come to the Muhammad. Library now needs to follow the push model in place of the pull model. Now you are, as a library, I am pushing my resource here. So they are searching my catalog here. It's integrated. I am running here an open source LMS called ILS called Koha. Now you see, so Gitanjali retrieved. So it can give me how many copies are there and which copies available or not. Normal typical OPAC service. But apart from that, you see, if this particular book is available in open access channel, there are many open access book channels. Open Library, Hathi Trust, Internet Archive, then many books. So suppose anywhere it is available, my student can read from here. As Nimai said, that we need to reduce our dependency on physical item. Now you see the same physical item, if it is available, I can write here, I can read the document. page by page. So like just like a Kindle, I can even download the book, I can search the book. So all kind of resources are possible. So you can download the PDF file, you can search, you can do anything, or you can simply read. So my student can read. And the next thing is that, as some of you are from teacher, so another possibility we are exploring, that if Gitanjali is there, so can I pack together all the verse or poems included in Gitanjali to create a text analysis service? Now if I click this one, so it can create a text analysis service for me. What are the top terms for Gitanjali? I can always reduce the size. Now you see here, I can increase the number of terms. So these are the top terms, those who are coming in big word in this one. I can go for many other text analysis. Like you see, let me try this one. How one word in Gitanjali related to other words? So links. So it can automatically generate links. Now again, I can increase this one, the context. Or I can even do a context level search. Say Amar came 17 times in Gitanjali. How Amar is related to other terms? If I click Amar here, you see the network will be built related to the Amar. Then many other things. I can create a weighted term bubble. So here you see bubbles. And each bubble can produce, there are 612 unique weighted term. Each bubble can create a sound event. So there are 612 unique terms, and you see again the bigness of the bubble gives you how many times this particular term utilized by the author here, Rabindranath Tagore. So in this way we can go for different kind of innovative services. Another one, let me show you, that is called TechStart. In real time, it can provide the link between different kind of words on the basis of weighted term frequency. So here you see how automatically it can give you how he is related to Tomar, Sokol. So in this way, it can create a weighted term frequency. Excellent tool for the people who are doing diplomatic research, text analytics, and language research. Even for students also, sometimes it's very useful for write down a note kind of thing, a quantification of a particular text. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much for allowing me. Now I am handing over the floor to the coordinator.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your presentation. Now I would like to introduce Dr. Saptarshi Ghosh, Associate Professor, University of North Bengal. He is requested to present his topic, Reopening Library in the New Normal, Current Context. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
is your desktop is visible?
Yes. Okay.
Thank you. sorry to disturb. We cannot see the slide. You check that whether someone just now it is available. Now it is available. Now yes, available.
Thank you.
Yes. Correct. Thank you. Many thanks. So correctly said.
Thank you, sir. So if you have any questions to the participants that I have asked, so you can put your questions on the chat box.
Hello, are you getting me? Yeah, are you getting me? No, Dr. Sir, I have a question. Okay, I just
hello.
Yeah.
I can hear you. Tell me.
Good afternoon, sir. Bhalo achen to. Actually, just I want to know what would be the role of the academic library to organize such type of information or sources of information for the benefit of the students and faculties or other academic communities.
Okay, you already know the rules and the tools, Salam. The thing is that what I meant here is basically lot many open access resources are available, 200 billion, more than rather 200 billion. Already expert estimated that 47% of the knowledge is open now, and by 2030, 100% will be open. But the problem is that these open access resources are distributed throughout the world under different services. And as a library professional, your role will be a navigator, so that you can discover these things, build awareness amongst your academic colleagues and students, if possible integrate those services inside your library system so that they don't have to roam around different places. So this is the role. You identify, discover, get the REST API search things and integrate inside your library OPAC, and if possible within the e-learning system. Because again, I am again in a state of fear that just like your idea, your plagiarism check, this e-learning is again going to come to the library professionals only. So we need to know the new ball game. And that new ball game is the VLE and how to integrate our existing academic library services inside that the coming rapidly emerging VLE platform.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Thank you for it.
Okay. I think there is no question there. I, on the behalf of my college and also behalf of my principal, honorable patron, Dr. Shagochandra Bandyopadhyay, extend very hearty thanks to all the speakers for their speech, presentation, and sharing their opinion and knowledge with us today. Thank you very much, sir. And also, thanks to all participants. that they are sparing time with us. And now I
Samayda. Hello.
Hello.
Samayda.
Hello.
Sir, bolchi. Ek minute. Haan. Shunte pachho?
Haan, sir. Haan,
haan, haan. Thik ache. হ্যাঁ আলোচনা অত্যন্ত সমৃদ্ধ। হ্যালো, আমি আমি ওই এক কথা বলতে চাইছি, একটা কথা শুরু করেছিলাম এবং শেষটার কথাটা একটা একটা কথা শুধু আমার এখানে বলার। হ্যালো, অনেক কিছু লেফট করে গুল করি, যাই হোক। হ্যালো, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, আমি প্রত্যেক হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ স্যার, আমি 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 অত্যন্ত আমি মন দিয়ে একবারে প্রথম থেকে শেষ পর্যন্ত অনেক সময় আমার নানান কাজে হয়তো চলে যায়, আজকে কিন্তু পুরোটাতেই আছি। হ্যাঁ পুরো হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, এই যে আপনাদের আমি হ্যাঁ আমিও একসময় লাইব্রেরি সায়েন্সের স্টুডেন্ট ছিলাম, পরীক্ষা দিইনি বর্ধমান বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ে, পরবর্তী ক্ষেত্রে ইউজিসি স্কলারশিপে, যাই হোক আমার এটা বলার জন্য আমি এই যে করলাম না, আলোচনায় অত্যন্ত সমৃদ্ধ হলাম, নানা দিগন্ত নানা কিছু, কিন্তু ওই যে লাস্ট মানে যে কথাটা আর কি, সেই যা বর্তমান একটা কঠিন পরিস্থিতি, আপনি মনস্তাত্ত্বিকতার দিকটাকে খুব সুন্দর করে বললেন এবং নলেজফুল লাইব্রেরি সায়েন্স আমাদের বর্তমান বিশ্বে গ্লোবালাইজেশন যে ভুবন যে গ্রাম, আমরা সকলেই বিশ্ববাসী, কিন্তু এখন এই যে একটি অদৃশ্য হ্যাঁ অদৃশ্য ভাইরাস আমাদের একবারে শারীরিক মানসিক সামাজিক এমনকি প্রাক্ষোভিক অর্থাৎ ইমোশনাল এই যে চারটে দিক নিয়েই তো আমাদের স্থিতি, এই সমস্ত স্থিতিটাকে যে একেবারে দুমড়ে মুচড়ে একাকার করে দিয়েছে স্যার, যার জন্যে এই স্থিতিকে হ্যাঁ এই এই যে এটা এটাই এত বড় মাপের একটা ব্যাপার, এই শরৎচন্দ্র চিরন্তন কথা হ্যাঁ গগনবাবুদের ঘরে আমাদের মুঙ্গেরি গেলা বন্দুক আছে হ্যাঁ লাও লাও লাও, কিন্তু লাও তো বটে অনেকে হ্যাঁ মানে মেন ফেন্সটা হচ্ছে কিন্তু ওই জায়গায় গিয়ে ঠেকে যাচ্ছে, আমাদের বিরাট পরিকল্পনা কিন্তু তার জন্য অর্থ আমি আমি যতটুকু খুব মাইন্ডফুলি ইয়ে করে আমার সাথে কন্ট্রোলের মানে সমস্ত আলোচনাটা এটাই কিন্তু আমাকে বারবার করে হিন্ট করছে স্যার, আপনারা একটু ভাববেন হ্যাঁ আমাদের ওই সাধ্য যেটা এই ব্যাপারটা একটা একটা আঘাত। হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, তো আমি আমরা খুবই সমৃদ্ধ হলাম, খুবই আলোচনা সমৃদ্ধ এবং প্রত্যেককে আমাদের প্রতিষ্ঠানের তরফে সময় তো বললেই কোঅর্ডিনেটর, আমিও প্রতিষ্ঠানের তরফে আন্তরিকভাবে প্রত্যেকের কাছে কৃতজ্ঞ, আমরা অত্যন্ত সমৃদ্ধ হলাম আপনার বক্তব্যে। হ্যাঁ সবাই ভালো থাকুন, কিন্তু ভাইরাস কে কাকে কতটা ভালো থাকতে দেবে একটা জিজ্ঞাসার চিহ্ন নিয়েই জগতে মানে থামতে হবে। খুব ভালো লাগলো। ঠিক।